sun. I worship you with devotion. I worship you with devotion. I worship you with devotion. I worship you with devotion.
Hi guys, my name is Theon.
Hi guys, my name is Nati.
And we're back on our new episode of I Never Knew, which is a short video we post bi-weekly here on YOTC. And in this series, we explain the Ethiopian Orthodox Tewahedo traditions so that the younger generations would have a deeper understanding of the meanings of our communal worship and other rites. In the prophecy of Hosea chapter 4, verse 6, God spoke through the prophet saying, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, and without understanding what is happening in our church, we won't be interested to create the intimacy with our Savior." To address such issues, we started a while back to cover the Divine Liturgy and study each step within it. Now, in our last episode, we ended with our response to the priest when he sings, "Peace be unto you," and we responded, "The Holy Church." And when he says, "Pray for us," we respond by saying, "Virgin Mary, the Mother of God." And we'll continue today with the next part before the clergy start circling the altar and blessing the four directions. And the priest says, "Anti waetu," which means "you are." And we reply back saying,
"Ma'etent zewerk entez orki fihime esat."
This means, "You are the golden censer which carries the burning coal."
Buruk zenesa emmekdes.
And this means, "That is what the blessed took from the sanctuary."
Zeyserri hat'iate weidemessis gegae.
And this means, "For the remission of sin, the blot of our iniquity."
ዘውእቱ ዘእግዚአብሔር ቃል ዘተሰባ እምኔኪ.
That is the word of God who incarnated from Mary.
ዘአረገ ለአብሁ ርእሶ.
Who offered and raised himself to his father.
ዕጣን ወመስዋዕተ ስሙረ.
As a perfect and unblemished sacrifice.
ንሰግድ ለከ ክርስቶስ.
We kneel down and worship you, Christ.
ምስለ አቡከ ኄር ሰማያዊ.
With your compassionate heavenly father.
ومنفس قدوس ماهياوي.
And the Holy Spirit, who is the life giver.
اسمه مزعيك وعدان كنا.
Because Christ, you did come and save us.
So this hymn has a very deep and magnificent meaning. From the beginning of the incense prayer, the priest is holding a censer. And this censer is a container where incense is burned. And the priest is moving it back and forth so that the smoke would raise upwards. The censer is an integral part of this prayer. Then the priest says at the end that the censer that he's holding is a symbolization of the Virgin Mary herself, because the sacrifice of incense is not what will blot out our sins and transgressions, and restore our salvation. It's her Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ. So as the censer holds the very hot coal that is burning to give an appealing smell, the Virgin Mary is also holding the divine fire and that divine Son of God, the Father, that took flesh from her. And how the smoke would raise upwards, she will similarly raise our prayers to the beloved Son. That is why our fathers see fit to mention her at this point. And this is biblical in that the prayer of the righteous is associated with incense in front of God's throne, as it says in Revelation 8:3. Then another angel with a gold incense burner came and stood at the altar, and a great amount of incense was given to him to mix with the prayer of God's people, as an offering on the gold altar before the throne. The smoke of the incense mixed with the prayers of God's holy people ascended up to God from the altar where the angels had poured them out. On another note, the hymn also connects the metaphor of the Old Testament where Aaron, that we call the blessed in the hymn, took incense and placed it on the censer to offer a sacrifice to God, the God of Israel, in Numbers 1646. Moses also ordered Aaron, saying, "Take your censer and put incense in it, along with burning coals from the altar, and hurry to the assembly to make atonement for them."
And that Jesus Christ, the incarnate, even though he is sinless, was the sacrifice on the cross to offer himself to his Father. This is the atonement for our salvation. That is why we kneel down to Jesus Christ for choosing to die for our sins. And we also worship his compassionate Father who gave his only begotten Son for our redemption, and also the Holy Spirit who is the source and the life giver.
After this, we see the actions of the story in Joshua 6, when the wall of Jericho crumbled while the army marched in the circle of the wall. And this is a metaphor for the clergymen being the soldiers of God, which is why they would circle around the altar to symbolize how, with Jesus Christ's sacrifice, that our wall of sin is destroyed. Okay, guys, that's where we'll wrap up today's episode. We'll see you again in 2 weeks, where we actually do the reading part of the Divine Liturgy. Make sure to subscribe on our YouTube channel, which is Young
YOTC, yep. Instagram as well, and Facebook.
Yep, thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
I worship you with devotion. I worship you.